introduced to man-made radiation when you had your first chest X-ray. Other sources of radiation, such as nuclear energy, have been harnessed by man for beneficial uses. Nuclear energy serves as a vital resource in medicine, agriculture, industry, environmental protection, research, and generation of electricity. In medicine, many radioactive substances, such as radiopharmaceuticals, are indispensable in the diagnosis and treatment of various diseases. In industry, radiation can be used to accurately find defects and imperfections in welds and castings, and to enhance industrial processes. In agriculture, nuclear technology is improving plant varieties such as rice and mung bean, making them yield higher and mature earlier. Safe, peaceful, productive. This is Nuclear Technology Today. The Philippines entered the nuclear age in 1958 with the creation of the Philippine Atomic Energy Commission. In 1987, it was renamed the Philippine Nuclear Research Institute, or PNRI. It is one of the research and development institutes of the Department of Science and Technology. As the center of all nuclear science and technology activities in the country, the PNRI is mandated to perform the following functions: conduct research and development on the applications of radiation and nuclear techniques, materials, and processes; undertake the transfer of research results to end users; operate and maintain nuclear research reactors and other radiation facilities; and license and regulate the possession and application of all nuclear and radioactive substances. To meet its objectives, PNRI implements these programs: nuclear research and development, nuclear services, nuclear safety and regulations. The Institute's programs in nuclear research and development focus on applications of radiation in food and agriculture, industry, biomedicine, and the environment. Research on crop improvement using radiation sources has produced mutant crop varieties of rice, mung bean, soybean, and ornamentals which have improved qualities. Studies using nuclear techniques are also being undertaken to help sustain soil fertility and to estimate soil erosion in agricultural areas. PNRI scientists use a nuclear technique called sterile insect technique, or SIT, to control the population of fruit flies that infest export fruits like mangoes. To detect the peak reproductive cycle of cattle and carabaos, scientists also use a nuclear technique called radioimmunoassay. This is an important strategy in improving livestock reproduction. PNRI's research studies on food irradiation have shown that this technology can prolong the shelf life of agricultural products, disinfest grains and export fruits, and reduce or destroy microorganisms in food commodities. In industry, PNRI is at the forefront of developing and characterizing high technology materials. These materials are important in the fabrication of modern electronic and electrical devices and gadgets. With the nuclear technique known as gamma ray column scanning, it is now possible to see inside a steel process vessel and quickly detect and identify problems without interrupting normal plant operations. Radiation is detectable even in small amounts. Hence, radioisotopes are used by PNRI as tracers to follow the movement of materials in industrial processes. In the field of biomedicine, the Institute has developed hydrogels from carrageenan and polyvinyl pyrrolidone. These hydrogels can be used as dressing for burns, wounds, and bed sores. The PNRI has developed a chitosan injectable hydrogel that can be used to cure the common urologic anomaly associated with urinary tract infection in children. PNRI studies have shown the effectiveness of gamma radiation in safely sterilizing locally manufactured medical products and pharmaceuticals. The PNRI has long been monitoring natural radioactivity in the environment and global radioactive fallout through measurement of ambient gamma radiation and analysis of environmental samples. Radiological assessment of technologically enhanced naturally occurring radioactive materials in the Philippine environment is also being conducted. Nuclear techniques are also useful in air pollution research. PNRI applies nuclear and related analytical techniques in identifying and quantifying the major sources of air pollution and estimating the contribution of these sources. Radioactive tracers are used to determine whether toxic chemicals from landfills reach the groundwater. Isotope and chemical techniques are used to analyze groundwater systems for better management of water resources. These methods can also be used in landfills to determine if there is contamination of the groundwater due to waste materials. The PNRI has been undertaking research on the use of nuclear techniques to assist in the management of red tide or harmful algal bloom in some aquaculture areas in the country. As the national focal point for the Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty Organization, the Institute coordinates the operation of the radionuclide monitoring station in Tanay, Rizal, the seismic stations in Davao and Tagaytay, and the National Data Center at PNRI. PNRI extends specialized nuclear and allied services to clients from industrial, business, medical, government, and academic sectors. These services are provided to encourage and widen the safe and peaceful uses of nuclear science and technology in various fields. The multipurpose irradiation facility and the gamma cell 220 are the facilities used by PNRI in providing gamma irradiation services. The multipurpose irradiation facility is used on a semi-commercial scale for food irradiation, medical product sterilization, and research applications. The gamma cell 220 is used for research and development studies and for irradiation of small volume of samples. Radiation protection services are extended to licensed users of radioactive materials in the country. This is to ensure that exposures of workers occupationally exposed to radiation are monitored and controlled. For the calibration of radiation protection instruments and devices, the Institute operates and maintains a secondary standards dosimetry laboratory, which is designated as the National Reference Laboratory for Ionizing Radiation. The PNRI operates the only centralized radioactive waste management facility for low-level radioactive wastes in the country. This provides for the treatment and temporary storage of immobilized, disused radioactive sources and other waste packages for future transfer to a final repository site. For trace analysis of various products and for certification of compliance of food export to non-radioactivity standards, clients may avail of the nuclear-based analytical services provided by the Institute. Radiation monitoring and protection instruments. These can be designed, fabricated, and repaired by highly skilled PNRI technicians. Human chromosomes can be analyzed at the PNRI Cytogenetics Laboratory to assess possible exposure of workers to high doses of radiation or environmental pollution, and to detect abnormalities or genetic disorders like Down syndrome. Thousands of Filipinos have become aware of the beneficial uses of nuclear science and technology through the Institute's information, education, and communication program. The activities under this program include the following: development and distribution of nuclear information materials, the conduct of nuclear awareness seminars, video showings and guided tours of the PNRI facilities. The Institute also participates in science and technology fairs and exhibitions and establishes media linkages. Researchers in need of up-to-date information on nuclear science and technology will find the biggest collection of materials at the PNRI library. The PNRI's computer services designed and developed an online web-based nuclear knowledge portal named the PNRI Web Center for Nuclear Knowledge Resources. The PNRI's Nuclear Training Center provides training in nuclear science and technology, radiation safety, and non-destructive testing for professionals and technicians in various sectors. The Institute also offers thesis advisorship, apprenticeships, and on-the-job training for students and researches on applications of nuclear technology. Nuclear safety and regulations is another major program of PNRI. It ensures the safety and protection of workers occupationally exposed to radiation and of patients subjected to radiation treatment and diagnosis. The program also ensures the protection of the general public against the possible risks of radiation exposure. Licenses are issued by PNRI to institutions, firms, and companies for the authority to use, own, store, sell, transfer, import, and export radioactive materials in the Philippines. The PNRI is the regulatory authority to ensure the safety of the future utilization of nuclear power in the country. The PNRI conducts inspection and audit of licensed radioactive material users and facilities to monitor and assess licensees' compliance with the PNRI regulations and the specific conditions of the license issued. To further enhance its regulatory functions, the PNRI continues to develop regulations, standards, guides, and bulletins which ensure radiation safety and security of radioactive materials. To detect illicit shipments of nuclear and other radioactive materials in the country, the PNRI manages the implementation of the Megaports Initiative project. This project involves the installation of radiation detection systems at the ports of Manila, among others. In collaboration with relevant agencies in the government, PNRI closely coordinates the continuing effort to build the capability of the country to respond in the event of a radiation-related emergency. This is being done through the implementation of the National Radiological Emergency Preparedness and Response Plan. Local linkages and collaborations are made by PNRI with other government agencies and scientific institutions, the academe, and the private sectors to enhance the Institute's nuclear capability. On an international level, the PNRI serves as the link between the International Atomic Energy Agency, or IAEA, and government and private entities using nuclear energy. The IAEA is a United Nations body on atomic energy matters. Majority of the country's nuclear-oriented projects receive support from the IAEA in terms of fellowships, training, equipment grants, technical cooperation projects, research contracts, and expert services. The Institute has also cooperative agreements on nuclear technology with other international organizations. By committing itself to the advancement of nuclear science and technology, the PNRI has forged the peaceful application of nuclear energy into an exciting and potent tool for national development. With its untiring efforts and exacting leadership, the Institute has placed the country in the League of Nations, which are enjoying the benefits of nuclear energy in their march to progress. Its priority projects have shown that nuclear energy has always been our ally, quietly advancing medicine, agriculture, and industry, and that a better public understanding of its nature and potentials for development can put this nation on the fast lane towards industrialization. In its 5 decades of leadership in nuclear science, the Philippine Nuclear Research Institute has proven that nuclear technology can work for each Filipino, giving him a better quality of life now and in the years to come.